Another day in Lords Mobile. Hey, there's Mr. BP. What's up, BP? Anywho, what shall we do today, guys? Hang on a minute.
NANI?!
What the fuck? What's going on, guys? It's your boy, Worthy Prince, coming at ya with another Lords Mobile video, and today, guys, I'm gonna kill an owl. That's right, actually, well, I mean, sort of. not animal cruelty, don't worry, guys. We're gonna kill this owl, Hootclaw. Yes, there is a new update to Lords Mobile. I kind of knew they were gonna sneak something in, because they've done like a 5-minute sneaky maintenance at like 3:30 this morning. Why was I awake at 3:30? I don't know, guys, I couldn't sleep. But anyway, there was a 5-minute like refresh and nothing happened, and I thought, yeah, something don't feel right, something's fishy here. And woke up this morning and look what I see, this little dude sitting here. So we have a new monster in Lords Mobile. It's not a special event, it's actually a full-on new monster to the rotation, okay? And there's some new gear as well and a new pack and all that good stuff, and we're gonna dive into it right now. Now, before I get into the gear and before I get into any of that, I want to play with a monster because this is the interactive part that I want to actually do before I do anything. And I'm gonna kill a level 5 for you. It takes about 5 minutes, so please bear with me. And this is the dude here. Look at this guy. He looks pretty cool, right? I think as far as character design, artwork, I think usual IGG style, he looks rather nice. I think it's a pretty cool looking monster. Anyway, if we take a look at the information, you can see he's strong against high physical defense, which means you don't want to be sending Demon Slayer and Tracker and all those good people over towards him. You want to go ahead and send magic heroes, probably a healer as well. It says the Hootclaw is a horrifying beast that targets the hero with the most HP remaining. Its massive wingspan lets it attack from long range, bring healers and use magic users to ruffle its feathers. So it tells you right there, bring healers and magic users to ruffle its feathers. All right, okay. Let's go ahead and see how long it takes to kill a level 5. My energy has been depleted because of the Bon Appetit. Thank you so much, Bonds. And this is the ultra rare right here, the Lunar Crest, okay? That's your main pay-to-play item right there, the Lunar Crest. And then free-to-play items here, here, and here. Guess what? There's a new free-to-play piece of gear. I know! We're going to get to it very soon. Don't worry, guys. First of all, let's kill the monster. Level 5. Hopefully the first level 5 Hootclaw killed on YouTube. Should be pretty fun, right? Let's check it out. So we're going to go ahead and choose our team. So, Magic. Kronika. It's time. I got this the other day and I was like, this is our monster hunting hero. Well, now, Chronicler, your time has come to step up and show us what you can do. Let's have a look and see what other magic heroes we've got that we could send. So first of all, Pixie. It's got to be Pixie, right, for monster hunting. She's in lots of monster hunting lineups. We're going to need a tank, I think, for a level 5. I'm going to go with Child of Light, maybe? Child of Light? Should we go Child of Light? I think Child of Light. We use him for some of the monster hunting as well. And then we've got Petite Devil. It's really high magic. And I think Witch Doll's really good too, but I'm going to go for Incinerator because she's also on a lot of monster lineups. So there you go, guys. That's my Hootclaw lineup. A tank for the front, which is going to be Child of Light. We've got a healer, and then we've also got three of the others as well. Three good magic heroes. I tell you what, I probably could. Oh, now I'm thinking about it. Take Incinerator out and put Loreweaver in. Bring healers. It was plural. Bring healers. Let's try this first. Let's try this. Okay, so that's my team with Loreweaver as well. So we're going to go ahead and deploy that first march. How much damage am I going to do? 0.5. That kind of sucked. Okay. All right, 0.5 is pretty low. Let's go ahead. That's wow. Okay, let's take out Loreweaver. Let's give ourselves some more firepower. And let's hit that and see what damage we do this time. 1%. Wow, that jumped up a massive amount. Okay, okay. Now let me change the tank and see if I can make a difference here. Okay, so taking out Child of Light, we're going to go for... Who's the other tank we use on monster hunting? It's going to be Centaur. Where are you, Centaur? There you are. Let's try a Vengeful Centaur out. And 84. No, that's bad. That's bad. Reverse. Take him out. Okay, let's take out Centaur. Let's go back to our original plan of Child of Light. I think that worked pretty well, actually, to be honest. I like it. I'm going to take Chronicler out now and see if it makes a difference with her not being there. Snow Queen. Is Snow Queen better than Chronicler? Well, 1.1, but I have gained damage because I've hit it a couple of times since then. Don't prove me wrong now, Chronicler. Give me a higher attack. Here we go. With Chronicler in. Yeah, it is. I think Chronicler's alright. That's my team then I'm going to go with for the moment, killing this boss. This monster. That there. That works pretty well. I'm sure there'll be some loads of testing going on to try and get the best performance team, but so far this looks pretty good. So we're going to roll with this and try and kill it now. And I'm sure there'll be lots of people watching to try and poach my monster, so I won't be doing none of those max hits until I get to the end. So let's try and get through this as quick as possible. And then we'll check out the drop rates and see if any of the items dropped from the monster hits. Which is, you know, that's what we're here for, right? To see what kind of drop rate we've got. Lumber Monster Energy got depleted the last couple of days, guys, because the Bon Appetites have been out and I've been hunting bons like you wouldn't believe. And I'm actually really happy to tell you guys, I just got my third cup to gold today, which is really, really good stuff. So yeah, really nice. My infantry set now has 3 cups in it, which is pretty cool. so yeah, it was really good to get my cup to gold. I managed to get a few gold, or a couple of golds and some purples over the rotation of Bon. And then I used some of my gems to basically finish off in Tycoon just before the Tycoon left at pack reset. I had it running last night, clicking on the old, at the elves, clicking on the old button through the night, giving me some extra halos. And when I woke up this morning, I woke up to the lovely present of a gold cup. So yeah, now we've just got to take it to Mythic, which hopefully shouldn't be too rough. But hopefully another couple of bomb rotations, we should be there. Anyway, we're not talking about Bond today, we're talking about this Hootclaw. As you can see, it's down to 80%. We're doing some pretty good damage. Team seems to be working pretty well. With good old Pixie. Nice, 2.4. It's not bad. 2.4 at 14 hits is not that sad. Magic ones always take a little bit more to kill. We know this anyway. So let's keep hitting. Now, the good thing is there's no jewels for this guy, as far as I'm aware. No, there's no jewels, right? No, there's no jewels. It's just gear. Thank God. When I saw there was a new monster for this gear, I was like, okay, all right. So there's new gear. Is there any new jewels? Is there any new monster jewels? They're like, no. I'm like, thank God for that, because I do not want any more monster jewels. Can you imagine if they brought out a new monster jewel for this that was like better than the worm jewel or something? Hell no. That would have pissed me off. Just got all my worm jewels done. Oh yeah, there's a new one. they're looking good though. Looking good. This went almost at 68%. Let's keep going. We're doing over 3% now, right? Yeah, we are. 3.01. Okay. Okay. Again, I really want to max hit this, but I just know there's... Did you guys know there's a guild out there that specifically steal monsters? That's their job. They're called the Super Stealer Squad or some shit like that. They're literally, it says it on their guild board. Their actual gameplay in this game is to actually steal people's monsters. And yesterday, we was all in the forest hunting level 5s, and... Like, they were literally just porting in on you when you had, like, 25, 30% left or whatever, trying to get your last hit, hoping you'd basically slip up and leave, like, 0.5% on your monster, so they could go ahead and take it off you. I mean, what? Like, who does that? I don't get it. Oh, my God. A whole guild specifically for stealing monsters. I mean, that's a madness right there. Okay, so 3% on one hit. So 3, 6, 9, 12, 8, 21... I might do a max hit here, guys. I know he's tempting fate, right? If I get my monster stolen while I'm doing this, I'm gonna go mad. But I think I should be alright doing a max hit here. Let's try it out. Oh shit. What's left? 25.6. That was I figured I could kill half of it with that. Let me just do one more little hit and then I'll smack it with a max energy hit. There we go, look. 21% left. No one's hitting that for 21%. Let's go ahead and do. There we go, look. Hootclaw. The first Hootclaw killed on YouTube. Let's get it! Level 5 Hootclaw is dead. Boom. Alright, look. Legendary Hootclaw from Prince YT. There you go. And let's open up this. And let's check out the box. Where is it? Legendary Hootclaw loot. Open it up. 150,000 ore. Let's get it. Hopefully someone in the guild got a better drop than me. Okay, so there's the monster, guys. Oh, we'll have a look at the actual... attacks. Should we look at the attacks? Where's the first hit? I want to see if all my heroes survive. Oh, did you see that? I got green free-to-play gear on the first hit. Let's have a look. I want to see the rewards as well. So let's see how we do here. Chronicler, going in. Got on Chronicler. Kick some butt with that painting. and I want to see if they survive. He stuns you. Do you see that? All the heroes spun up in the air. So he stuns. So it's good that we brought two stunners as well, right? Child of Light. Don't die, Child of Light. Okay, so Petite Devil and Pixie now. Boom, boom. He doesn't stun because he's a monster. Lawweaver doing some good damage. Oh, this was the first hit with Lawweaver, wasn't it? Okay, this kind of sucked. Okay, Petite Devil's going to die. No, she's not. Lawweaver heals her. Maybe we needed those two heroes. I don't know. It seemed like without Lawweaver, it done so much more damage though, right? 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All the heroes survived against level 5. That's good. That's a good thing, because then you're doing maximum damage. So, theory, that team worked. That team worked. Let me just check the one which didn't have Lawweaver in. Oh, look, we're getting more free-to-play items. All right, okay. Hey, I tell you what. Drop rates already. The first two hits. Look at this. First two hits on this monster, we got green items. That's not a bad shout. Okay, this one didn't have Lawweaver in. This is just Petite Devil. Let me look at this. Did they all survive? Because if they all survive, then this is a great team. That's what you look for in a level 5 team. You need them all to survive and do damage consistently throughout the battle. So let's have a look. Child of Light going in. Hopefully Incinerator is going to live because she always dies. I told you about Chronicler, didn't I? That is a new awesome magic hero. If you've got her leveled up, I mean, at grade, I don't know if she'll outperform some of the other magic heroes you already have. But if you have Chronicler, like purple gold potentially, she's going to be good. You're going to want to put her into your magic lineups for your magic monsters. Because she's a really solid monster hunting hero. I kind of figured that from the testing we done in the other video the other day when I kind of maxed it out. Big heal from Prima Donna. Chronicler going in with that painting again. Boom, eat that. Yeah, this team's quality. Look, they've all got their life. Solid team. That's my Hootclaw team for now, because that works really well. I think you need the tank up front as well. I may do some testing without the tank to see if I don't need it or not, because then I could do more damage. But we'll see. Anywho, let's check out the drops. So we got one of the Scarlet Feather green, nice, and we got Wild Fruit green. Okay, nothing. We got two more Scarlet Feathers. We're looking for Lunar Crests, obviously. That's the big ultra rare. But I don't think I'll get some of my first one. That'd be a bit insane. Some resources, some speed ups. We also got one of these blue Weeping Wood. Okay. That's actually good, because these Weeping Woods only show on the pay-to-play stuff. So, yeah, I need those. And a green one. Hey, give me the materials. Let's go. A blue Wild Fruit. I mean, this is just off one monster, guys. And already I'm getting enough here to pick up some of the... Some of the free-to-play stuff here, which is pretty good. One green one as well. There we go. 1,000 gems. 5 green Weeping Woods. All right. A purple Scarlet Feather. Okay. Well, that would be basically my purple, my free-to-play cavalry helmet if I was building that. There you go. Anyway, look, this is a level 5, so I'm going to get some higher drops. You guys might not be able to hit level 5s if you're new to the game, but as you can see, they're dropping materials. The material drops seem okay. Let's go and have a look at the actual gear. Okay guys, so if we take a look in the gear cabinet, we can see there is a new section, Hootclaw set. Now, there's a few pieces here. There's 4 pieces of gear in the new set. And the free-to-play piece, let's start with that one first, right? So we've got Stringing Hood. Now this is cavalry helmet. It comes with 9.8% cavalry attack, 14% cavalry HP, and 4.2% army HP at mythic grade. Now, as for a cavalry helmet, it's okay. I mean, the Berserker Tusk Helm is the one which is, I guess, the counterpart that's already out. The Berserker Tusk Helm has a bit more attack, but it doesn't have any of the HP. So I think if you compare the Berserker Tusk Helm to the Stringe Hood, I actually think that the Stringe Hood is probably maybe a little bit better. It certainly looks a lot better than the Berserker Tusk Helm anyway, but to be honest with you, it's still not really best in slot for free-to-play. You're still probably going to go for the Indulgent Visors just because it has more cold hard stats on the actual piece itself. So, a nice piece, it looks good. You could get some use out of it, but ultimately, not the best, I don't think, for free-to-play. But what do we expect? Free-to-play always get the rough end of the stick a little bit with stuff with gear and stuff, so it kind of is what it is. Now moving on to the next one, we've got Stealthy Steps. Now this is a pre-level 60 piece of gear. You don't need to be level 60 to get it. So what's it going to offer? It's going to give 22.4% range attack, 28% range defense, and 11.2% army max HP. Now, of course, this is best in slot for range if you're pre-level 60. If you're going to do a range blast, then these are the boots you want to be wearing. However, most people, generally speaking, when they play Lords Mobile on a new account, they don't normally build for spears at the early stage of the game. If anything, they build a mixed set. And to be honest with you, I think the free-to-play piece, the Honeycomb Chaps, these ones here, still remain best in slot for a mixed set. Yes, they don't have the range HP, but they do have over 32% worth of stats between cavalry and ranged on two troop tribes, not just one. So you're still probably going to go for a Mythic Honeycomb Chaps if you're pre-level 60. Because if you're going to go for the stuff after level 60, you're going to stick with the original best in slot Dragon's Talon, which is indeed better as far as a mixed piece goes compared to the new boots. And also, it smashes it on range. So what do I think about these new boots? I think they're okay. I mean, they will do a service for anyone that decides, I guess, to build a range blast set. Pre-level 60, not advised, mind you, but there you go. I don't think people are going to be rushing to the store or to their crafting table to build these Stealthy Steps, although the artwork does look nice. Also, the big deal breaker for me here is the fact these are pay-to-play items. Lunar Crescents on these? I think IGG done a boo-boo here, putting the Lunar Crescent on these boots. I think these would have been much better free-to-play. This would have given free-to-play a really nice pair of boots to get on this set. I mean, I think the Lunar Crescents is a massive mistake for this piece, but it is what it is, and free-to-play still will be able to probably get these, potentially from Monster Hunting. It's only two, okay? Now we move on to the business end of this gear update. We're talking about the Beastly Breastplate and the Lunar Boomerang. We're going to start off with the Beastly Breastplate. I'm kind of a little bit peed off with this one, because I'm currently working on building up my Champion Chestplate. So obviously I'm not really wanting to focus on any other ranged chest piece right now. And of course a ranged chest piece comes out. Now this one, a Mythic Raid's got 49% ranged attack, 21% ranged HP, army defense 28%. What does that mean? Well, putting it simply, guys, it basically takes the original one which everyone uses for range blast, the Hardened Carapace, and shoves it down the toilet. This has been blown out the water. This is 35% range attack. That's it. I mean, army defense, yeah, I mean, okay, thank you for that. But 35% range attack is the selling point on this Carapace. And when you compare 35% range attack to 49 and 21% HP, and it's got the army defense as well, I mean, this is it. If you're not going champion, but buy a Carapace, it's now time to focus on your Beastly Breastplate. Which is actually, I guess, when you really think about it, not a bad thing, considering most people that aren't going champ want to build a Bumble Helm, they want to build a Carapace. I guess now there's just one item in the Bumble set to focus on, the Bumble Helmet, with your Honey Venom. So I guess it's not a bad thing, I guess. But yeah, do I want to get this? I kind of do for my range blast, but I also kind of don't because I'm working on a champion piece. And talking about champion pieces, check it out. At Mythic Raid, of course, the champion chest piece holds its own at 56% range attack plus 35 HP. You're not beating that. This is still the best in slot range chest piece in the game. However, many people in this game don't use that for range. They use this, the legendary one, which I've almost got. I'm working on it. It's getting there. And I was planning on putting my gold chest piece into my range set, which I still will do, to be honest with you, once it goes to gold. But look at the stats. 40% range attack, nice. 42% army defense, so pretty much almost double the amount of army defense. And then 25% army HP. Okay, so 25 HP, 40 attack, 15% HP. So I wish it wouldn't go up. Go down, go down. 22, hang on, 22, no, wrong one. Where is it? 25 HP, 15 HP. So it loses 10% army HP. Wrong one. It's gold. Sorry, guys. Yeah, the actual HP is down by 4% and then 49% range attack. So it's actually more powerful than a legendary champion plate. That's insane. This is actually better than a legendary champion plate. So Do I want it? Yes. Do I want to spend my ultra rares on it right now? No. Do I want to go for the next one? Yes, and we're going to get to that right now. But ultimately, guys, Best Piece of the Breastplate is the new best in-slot range chest piece in the game. Only thing that beats it is Mythic Champion Plate. So if you're not going for champion gear, build this, okay? Go for the Beastly Breastplate, all right? Okay, moving on to the last piece of gear, the one which I've got my eye on. The Lunar Boomerang. This looks awesome. Look at that boomerang. I love the look of it. Cavalry Attack, 42%. Cavalry Defense, 21%. Cavalry Max HP, 21%. Now, people that aren't champion for Cavalry, if you know what you're doing, we'll go for this piece here for your Mythic Offhand. Dragon's Fist, 30% Cavalry Attack, 28% Army HP. Okay. Yeah, this is better. It's got 12% more attack stats for a start. Loses a little bit on the HP, just a smidge, 7%, but you gain so much more attack that ultimately becomes the best in slot Mythic offhand for Cavalry. And if we're comparing to Champion, because of course we're going to compare to Champion, it actually beats the Gold Champion Qatar. Like, it destroys it. 100% better than a Gold Champion Qatar. And if you go to Mythic Grade, 49% Cav Attack, Army Defense, Training Speed, Range Attack. There's not much really else there that's going to get me excited for Cavalry. It's just the Cavalry Attack, 49%. And this here comes with 42, so you're losing 7%, but you're gaining 21% Cavalry Max HP. That's going to be a real interesting one, because some people are going to probably switch from the Mythic Qatar to the Lunar Boomerang for the HP. And others may not, when they're doing a spear attack maybe, I don't know, but I'm just saying, that looks really cool. That's pretty much, as far as I can see, on par with a Mythic Qatar. That's really good stuff, really good stuff. So that Lunar Boomerang is amazing, definitely best in slot in my eyes, and definitely the best piece of gear that's come out with this set for your offhand. So yeah, really good. I mean, the cost difference is going to be insane. It costs you thousands to get a Mythic Qatar, and it'll cost, I don't know yet, but it should cost you a lot less to get a Lunar Boomerang. As far as ultra rares go, it's going to be 7 apiece for the Lunar Crest. These are the ultra rares, okay? And then, of course, Beastly Breastplate. You can see there, Mr. BP going for the legendary. I just done that a minute ago. I'm going to do mine in a second. And yeah, 7 here as well. So, 2 really good bits of gear. Lunar Boomerang, Beastly Breastplate. Now, guys, there is a new pack in the store. Let's just get this done now. It's a new pack in the store. Hootclaw set. As you can see, it's up to 100 on my screen right now. And that's what you get in the 100 pack. You can see the 120 of each of the ultra rares, all the items, 560 chests, and a bit of resources as well. And I can show you the process and like the upwards way they go. Let's check it out. Look, this was the $5 pack, come with 10 and 50. Okay, that's your basic $5 pack. Then I've got the next one, which is the 20, comes with 125 chests, comes with 25 of each of the items. And then got the 50, which is going to be 300 Hootclaw chests and 60 of each of the items. It's not a bad amount of items, to be honest. And then go to the double it, go to 100, the pack doubles. It goes to 560 chests, and you get 120 of the ultra rare and down. So pretty much, if you buy one full run, you can see from my, you can see from the amount of Lunar Crests I've got. Come out of there. If I click to forge and click here, you can see I've got 215 commons from a full run. So that's a 5, a 20, a 15, a 100. So you need 256 for a gold. So it's like 3 purples and almost a 4th. So it's almost a gold from a full run. So that's basically what you're looking at. So talking about cost-wise of how much it would cost to get a legendary Lunar Boomerang, and there's 7 of these, you'd probably need to buy like 7 or 8 full runs. So you're probably looking at still around about, I don't know, you're looking at somewhere around about $1,400-$1,500 if you're going to max it out in one go to legendary. Probably about $1,400-$1,500, something like that. If you're buying the packs at like 100, 100, 100, I'd say maybe a bit less actually now I think about it, because it goes up to 100, you'd need 700, 800. No, a bit less actually, maybe about 900, maybe about 850, 900 if you want to get to legendary. Just off the back of these commons, but we've still got chests to open, so maybe it's even less. And I've got some chests, look. I don't know, I'm just thinking out loud regarding the chests. But you get 1,000 chests from the full run. So if we're going to get some drops here, maybe it'll really work even less. I don't know. I don't know what the drop rate's going to be like. We're about to find out. I'll tell you something. I like the look of the chests. I think the chests look good. So let's just go into it and see how we do. I'm just going to open up some of these useless ones quickly, guys. And then we're going to actually build some of the gear, hopefully. Anyway, I hope so, anyway. So let's have a look. And of course, if I need to get some more packs, I can. It's not a problem. All right, so what we'll do, we'll do 50s, yeah? We'll do 50s. Okay, let's go ahead and do 35 first. And get rid of that. Okay, so 2 Lunar Crests, common. Okay, that's not a great start. Uncommon, I've got some greens there as well. We need the Lunar Crest, that's the bottom line. I'm going to do them in hundreds, actually. You know, let's just do hundreds. Let's just ball it. Okay, 100. All right, okay. Legendary Wild Fruit. Okay, that's okay. We're going to... It's not the Ultra Rare. I got a blue Lunar Crest, though, which is pretty good. And 5 commons. Okay, well, blue straight off the bat isn't a bad sign. Let's have a look at the next 100. Okay, 3 commons. Ooh, okay, so the drop rate's not like the voodoos then. It's not like the familiar chests. Uh-oh. 100. Okay, we get another 2 of those wild fruits. 7 common lunar crests. I'm not enjoying these commons though. I'm really not. Oh, that's worrying a little bit. Okay, let's keep going. Another 100. Okay, epics in the house, but not the one I'm looking for. 3. Oh, you know, they've definitely got a better drop rate than Halos by the looks of it. But it's still not amazing. Another 100. Another blue. Okay. Kind of feels like, I don't know, it's not as good as Dragon Eyes. It's not as bad as Halos. Kind of feels like Blueprints a little bit. I don't know. Let's have another 100. Oh man, we're getting those legendary wild fruits though, right? Rare Lunar Chest again, so we get another blue. 3 blues now. This is rough, guys. This is rough. Another 100. Another 3 Lunar Chest. Wow. Commons again. This is a madness right now. Let's go for another 100. 1 green, 1 common. Ooh, it's pretty rough, I have to say. It's for 2 commons. What is this? IGG got some bad drop rates on these chests. That was terrible. Yeah, no, that was... Guys. I've spoken to some people this morning that went on Monster Hunt buses as well, and nobody got golds. Just a couple of purples. The drop rate is pretty dreadful on the chests. That's painful. Literally painful right there to see. Okay, look. Anyway, let's go and have a look and see what I can build. My goodness, that was a full run as well. So Lunar Boomerang, we're looking at common. Let's build the common up first. This is the one I'm going for, so I guess we'll build that. Okay, so now I need to move these up to green, right? So I can build my green Lunar Boomerang. And now I know I want to build the blue one. I can do it too. Okay. Let's go ahead and open some gold, right? And upgrade this to blue. Looks like I'm getting a blue one, guys. And I've got 2 purples towards my purple one. Well, kind of rough. I mean, plenty of this stuff. Look, I mean, I've got plenty of these things, these wild fruits. And yeah, look, I got 400 out of these. I got tons of them. I got these bloody, what are they called? Scarlet feathers and wild fruits for days. But the Lunar Crescents, purple after this purchase. So let's have a look. We're going to open 20. And then we're going to go ahead and crack on. Now we know that these wild fruits come up a lot. The Lunar Crest seems to be absent. Let's see if we can maybe try and get a really good drop on it. Again, 3. I mean, it's the same scenario. There's the blue. We got blues last time. So far, not seen a purple or a gold drop. I got a green that time as well though. And 2 commons. Okay. That wasn't bad. Probably the best drop I've seen. 2 commons and 2 uncommons. All right. Another 100. We get 1 green, 4 commons. My goodness. Okay, another 100. And again, 1 green and 4 commons. Okay. Here we go. Another 100. Wow. The, you know what? I think I should have just stuck with my guns from the last video. I said the drop rate was bad. And there's 2 blues. 2 blues. Okay, calm down, game. Calm down. 2 blues, wow, okay, that's probably the best drop ever I've seen so far out of 2,000 chests. Another blue, okay. It doesn't want to give anything other than a blue. There's 2 greens and 3 commons. Am I not going to get a gold out of 2,000 chests opened? I'm not, am I? 3 commons, wow. Okay, another 100. Oh, damn. Okay, so I want you guys to know I opened up 2,140 chests and I got no golds and I got no purples. That's terrible. Okay, it really is terrible. And can I upgrade it? I can, though. I can take it to purple. Now, that's good. That's a good thing. Okay, boom. There it is. 8. Okay, well, we did that. Let's get it upgraded. My goodness gracious, it's going to be hard to get this thing up. Let's go ahead and level it up. Boom. All right, so we are at gold. We are at purple now on the Lunar Boomerang. Yeah, like getting this up is going to be difficult, I have to say. To get that to legendary, it's as far as getting packs is concerned, you're going to need... I was trying to work it out, and basically, like, one full run gives you almost a gold. So you could basically do it in, like, get it to legendary in, like, 7 rotations. You would pretty much be there. So you'd be looking at around about $950 to $1,000 over 7 full-run rotations. You would be at probably a legendary grade. If I was to go ahead, oh my goodness gracious, and maintenance again. Like, just constant maintenance on this game right now. What? You know what? I hope IGG haven't messed up the actual drop rate and I'm getting, like, blues and lower because they messed something up and the golds and the purples ain't dropping. I don't know, but if it is, IGG, you're free to send me some of these gold lunar crests if I should have got it by now, because that looks massive. It's really expensive for one piece of gear. Just for a cavalry blast, it's expensive. So I'm just gonna roll with it a purple now for the moment and just slowly level this up, monster hunting, and maybe the odd 5 and 20 pack going forward, because I don't want to spend another 1,000 odd just to get it to gold based off these drop rates, and then potentially like another 1,000 to get it to mythic. So you're looking at like $2,000 just for one piece of gear. You know, yeah, it is on par with the Lunar Guitar and it doesn't cost as much as Lunar Guitar, but it's still bloody expensive. So yeah, you know, we'll see how that goes. Anyway, servers under maintenance, I'm done. Catch you later, peeps. Stay safe, and of course, peace out.